The Alliance of Concerned Teachers held a protest outside the Department of Budget and Management over the laptops provided to teachers that were found to be outdated and overpriced. Joyce Balancha now joins us with details. Joyce, over to you.
Yes, Carmina, public school teachers who are members of the Alliance of Concerned Teachers, or ACT, believe it is not enough that the Department of Education will invoke the warranty clause to upgrade or replace the outdated laptops that were given to them. For the teachers, someone has to be accountable for the purchase of these gadgets. Initially, the previous Deputy Administration requested to buy laptops for a price of 35,000 each, but the PSDBM instead bought units at 58,300 pesos each. Recently, the Commission on Audit flagged the said purchase, noting that there are other options for laptops that are faster yet cheaper in price. For this reason, the teachers held a protest in front of the Office of the Department of Budget and Management this morning to demand accountability. Mina Vibar, the Vice President of ACT NCR North Cluster, said using warranty is just one of the band-aid solutions to the problem. What the DepEd should do, she said, is to provide the teachers useful gadgets. Earlier, DepEd guaranteed that they have included in the proposed 2023 budget funds to buy added learning materials, including gadgets for teachers. ACT suggests that in the process of the next procurement, there should be a representative from teachers' groups who should be consulted on what exactly they need in order to provide quality education to students. They also demand that corruption be stopped in agencies that are involved in the procurement of things needed by the education sector. Meanwhile, Carmina, Senate Minority Leader Senator Coco Pimentel is seeking an investigation on this questionable purchase of the PSDBM. He filed a Senate resolution urging the Senate Blue Ribbon Committee to look into the matter. Carmina?
Thanks a lot. Joyce Balancha there. Take care, Joyce, and you keep safe. President Marcos seeking an enabling environment for the country's health research community, whom he says plays a huge role in the battle against the pandemic. Let's get more details now from our correspondent, Pia Gutierrez. Pia, over to you.
Hi, Carmina. We are here in Clark, Pampanga, where President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. led the opening of the 15th Philippine National Health Research System Week, where he was guest of honor and speaker. And during his speech, the president took time to thank the nation's health researchers for their invaluable contribution to the government's pandemic response, which he says helped in saving the lives of millions of Filipinos from the virus. During his speech, he recalled his first bout with COVID-19 back in 2020, back when very little was known yet about the COVID-19 virus and its treatment. And he said that the work of Filipino health researchers was very important as these paved the way for the country to access information about the virus, which was used effectively in the front lines. This was because the Philippine National Health Research System led the country's participation to the WHO Solidarity Trial. They were also instrumental in developing local COVID-19 test kits and treatments, such as the use of virgin coconut oil and others, as well as the development of evidence-based forecast systems that were used in policy decisions to respond to COVID-19. The president also stressed the importance of synergy and collaboration among different agencies, as well as the sharing of ideas and new information as the country continues to deal with the evolving pandemic situation. Carmina, the president also stressed that Malacanang is currently consulting with the House of Representatives as well as the Philippine Senate on measures seeking to create the country's own virology center as well as the Center for Disease Control and Prevention. This as he noted the need for government to respond more efficiently to public health emergencies such as the ongoing COVID-19 pandemic, as well as the need to prepare the country against the threat of emerging viruses. If you would recall, Carmina, the president earlier vowed to establish these centers as part of the administration's legislative agenda during his last State of the Nation address in July. Carmina?
Well, Pia, it's been, what, a month, over a month since he formally took office and still no health secretary? Any word on that?
No word on that yet, Carmina. We were trying to get an interview with the president, but we failed to interview him, and because that's what we wanted to know. It's already been a month since his own press secretary said that the government or the administration is already in the final stages of deciding on who will be the permanent health secretary of this administration, but no word yet on whether he will be appointing anyone anytime soon. As you know, that there's already an MC number 3, which says that the DOH OIC or any OIC of the government, which has yet to have a head yet, will be staying in office or in authority until the end of the year. So we do not know if the president plans to appoint a health secretary anytime soon, or he will wait until the end of the year before he does that. But the administration has been very keen in saying that the lack of a Department of Health secretary does not mean that there is no urgency on the part of the government to address the ongoing pandemic situation, as they stress that the OIC, which is Undersecretary Maria Rosario Vergara, is very capable in leading the Department of Health even during a COVID-19 pandemic, Carmina.
All right, Pia, so we continue to wait. Our very own Pia Gutierrez there joining us live from Clark.